A towering figure as divisive in death as he was in life.
George the Lionheart was dressed with the cross on his chest and ready, awaiting his master's return. 404 days in solitary confinement, on what he good-humouredly called his extended spiritual retreat.
This man is not a saint. This man is not a martyr.
He had a big heart too, strong enough to fight for the faith and endure persecution, but soft enough to care for priests, youth.
I was here to remember my friends who haven't survived their childhood sexual assault, their institutional assault.
Australia's most senior Catholic cardinal, George Pell, laid to rest.
Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn?
In attendance, former PMs and Pell supporters Tony Abbott and John Howard, Liberal leader Peter Dutton, and National Senator Matt Canavan.
George Pell was the greatest man I've ever known.
If he has two mates who are former prime ministers, he must be okay.
He stood up for what he believed, and I so much admired him.
I always regarded Cardinal Pell as a great Australian.
Just as notable, the absences, including the Prime Minister and New South Wales Premier, Dominic Perrottet.
Perrottet, with an election coming up, despite being a devout Catholic, is not attending it. People hate the guy.
Outside St Mary's Cathedral, protesters drowned out the proceedings for a full 10 minutes. And an LGBT rights march engulfed Sydney's streets. It follows an emotionally charged week.
Don't take your sign off. Don't get your people to move or they can go themselves.
Survivors tying ribbons to the fence, each a reminder of the victims the church failed to protect.
Why are you taking the ribbons off? Why don't you stop him taking the ribbons off?
Church bells rang out to a chorus of chants. Cardinal Pell, a polarising figure to the end.
This is not your average funeral, and it's so divisive, and I know that people feel so differently about whether or not you can protest a funeral. But this is as much about protesting George Pell, the man, as it is about the institution that he represents. There is so much unresolved. There are survivors of child sex abuse or the families of those people who have had their voices suppressed for so long. I completely understand their impulse to stand there and try and be heard. And, you know, it's a sad spectacle, but it also, if he wanted to have a really private funeral, they could have done that. This is thousands of people. We've got ex-prime ministers, we've got current sitting politicians. If it weren't for the protesters, this could look like propaganda. Yeah. Propaganda for the Catholic Church.
Even without the current prime minister there, without a devout Catholic New South Wales premier, like, don't you think, with no state funeral, which, by the way, we should make a point, because I'm astonished by the number of people I've spoken to today who think this is a state funeral.
It's not.
And it's just not at all.
No, and I think that that's an important point. It's not paid for by taxpayers,
yeah,
and that definitely makes a difference, but at the same time, it could have been a lot more private. Okay. And when we've got Tony Abbott standing up there going, the man is a modern-day saint, essentially, mm, I think that there's, you know, the right for a debate.
Well, part of the problem is George Pell has become the central figure in a culture war. And so yeah, that's what you get in this situation. But how do you feel, for example, about people going to, I don't know, the funerals of war veterans and protesting there because they hate the wars they fought in, or they want to protest, I don't know, the imperialism of the American project? Or...
Very uncomfortable. But I think that here it's a legacy is so unresolved. And you know what? If this is a reckoning moment for the Catholic Church, it's well overdue.
Do you think that's the reckoning moment, though?
I think it's part of it.
Or the Royal Commission, for example, and everything that's flowed from that?
Well, I think that there are still a lot of voices that haven't been heard, and I think that's why we're seeing what we're seeing today.